Huh?
What's wrong? Dad! It's okay. Oh my God.
Hello, NCIS fans. Welcome to a very special episode of our show where we dive deep into the landmark 1000th episode of NCIS. This isn't just any milestone. It's a celebration packed with suspense, heart, and some familiar faces. So let's decode all the thrills and spills of this epic episode. In this monumental episode, we start off with a bang, quite literally, as director Leon Vance, played by the ever-compelling Rocky Carroll, finds himself in grave danger. While paying respects at his late wife's grave, Vance has a tense conversation with his son, Jared, played by Spence Moore II. The tension is palpable, and just as it seems they might bridge their strained relationship, tragedy strikes, Vance is shot by a sniper. Rocky Carroll said, "When we talked about bringing back Vance's son, I thought, great, they'll reconnect. I didn't expect the twist of Vance getting shot. It was a shocker when I read the script." This traumatic event serves as a critical turning point, not just for Vance, but for his entire family, including his daughter, who's now an NCIS agent witnessing firsthand the dangers of the job. As Vance fights for his life, the NCIS team races against time to uncover the sniper. The twist? The shooter is linked to the franchise's very first episode, bringing the series full circle.
Well, that sounds like Gibbs.
After Rich was killed, the FBI found manifestos, all based on the quote.
The callbacks don't stop there. From guest appearances by Daniela Rua as Kenzie from NCIS LA, Vanessa Lockie as Jane from NCIS Hawaii, to Joe Spano. Reprising his role as Fornell, this episode is a treat for longtime fans, stitching together the expansive NCIS universe. The episode isn't just about nostalgia, it's also about passing the torch. With Vance temporarily incapacitated, he names McGee, played by Sean Murray, as the interim director.
Need someone to fill in as acting director.
Sean Murray says, "It's a big moment for McGee. From being the junior field agent to now, he's seen a lot, learned a lot. To be considered to take over from Vance, it's an honor." This decision isn't just about filling in. It's about trust and recognition of McGee's growth over the series. It hints at future leadership changes within NCIS, reflecting both continuity and change. As we celebrate this 1000th episode, we see themes of family, duty, and legacy woven throughout. The episode explores how close calls with death can reset priorities and mend fractured relationships. It's not until you think you might lose someone that you realize the importance of every moment, Rocky Carroll remarked about the episode's deeper message. This sentiment echoes through the team as they navigate personal and professional challenges. And before we wrap up, let's talk Easter eggs. This episode is sprinkled with references that only the keenest of fans might catch, linking back to deceased characters like Kate Todd and Tom Morrow, and even connecting to the daughter of a perpetrator from the series' inception. Rocky admitted he needs to watch the episode again to catch all these hidden gems. And maybe so do we. Each viewing can reveal something new, a testament to the rich layered storytelling NCIS is known for. From high-stakes drama to heart-to-heart moments, NCIS's 1000th episode is a milestone that delivers everything fans love about the show. Here's to many more episodes filled with action, intrigue, and, most importantly, family. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment with your favorite moment from this episode. Until next time, keep your friends close and your remote control closer.